Hey everybody, it's Juicy Box Man, and I'm here with some more The Legend of Zelda. In the last episode, we started our quest and started collecting the Overworld items, such as the blue candle, the white sword, the bombs. In this episode, we're going to finish up collecting these items. We need... there's only a few more. One of them very helpful. The others are helpful too, just not as... One of them is really good. And... we're gonna get another heart container, so the first thing we're gonna head off to do is get the magical shield. We need 90 rupees to purchase it, so we need one more rupee. Hopefully a Octorok will drop one. Please drop one rupee, Mr. Octorok, or hurt me. That's cool too. A heart. Okay, I guess that's alright. Alright, there's our rupee. Now we can... luckily, the magical shield is right above us, so we can just head up there and get it. Yeah, okay. It's on this very corner bush. Use your candle to reveal this secret entrance. And inside... boy, this stuff is really expensive. Not too bad. Magical shield is 90 rupees. Definitely worth it. This is gonna really help. Now we can do things such as, if it'll work, yep, we can block beams from Zolas, and this is really gonna help because there are other enemies that shoot beams like this later in the game, so, yeah, really gonna help. It's bigger, just provides more defense, so, yeah, this is one of the things you wanna get. Now we're gonna start saving up for arrows, in the first dungeon, which I'm not sure we're gonna cover in this video, just because... it would be a pretty lengthy video if I did. But we get the bow in the first dungeon, which you need arrows to fire. So yeah, we're gonna head for those next. They cost 80 rupees, I believe, and there are a few secret rupee locations on the way, so we're not really gonna have to grind against enemies to save for money, which is... I like that in this game, that you don't have to save up money like that. Right here, another secret rupee location. I think it only gives you 10, though. Let's see. It's a secret to everybody. Yes, you all say that. Alright, we got 30. Not bad. So, I think we need 16 more rupees to get the arrows. Now we need 10. Okay, head through the desert and down, and right below us is the cave where you can get the arrows at. Think about the arrows and the bow. I never really use them anytime I play this game. I mean, there are a few enemies later in the game that are required you use the bow and the arrow to defeat. We'll get to them later, but I don't really use it unless I really have to, because it wastes a rupee every time you shoot an arrow, and I never really understood why you would do that unless you have to. Because you do get the magic rod later in the game, which is basically just as powerful as the bow and requires no rupees to shoot it, and it has a bigger range, so yeah, definitely wait until you get the magical rod to do that. Over here, another secret rupee location. We only need 7 rupees to get the arrows though, but might as well. Alright, there's 10, so now we can go up and get the arrows. Whoop-dee-doo. Okay, yeah, I know these videos might be a little boring just because I'm getting all the items before I try any dungeons, and trust me, this is... if you play this game, you really want to do this because it's going to make... basically, you get all the items, then you can just go dungeon after dungeon after dungeon without worrying about what items or weapons you need, because you already have them. So, yeah, down here is going to be another secret rupee location. Just missed that guy pretty badly. I think it's this third bush right here. Yeah, there we go. There's a bit of lag right there. There's a lot of... that's one thing. In this game, if there's a lot of enemies on screen... there's a lot of enemies on screen. Yeah, that's right. There's a lot of enemies on screen. It's gonna create a bit of lag and... whoa! I didn't know this one was 100 rupees. I'll take it, though. Alright, where we're gonna head next... is to get... well, okay, we might as well start saving up for the blue ring now, which is the next item we're gonna need to get, because the blue ring basically gives you double the health and is really gonna be helpful. thing is, it costs 250 rupees, and your rupees max out at 255. So, yeah. I'm gonna need to save up a lot of rupees to get the blue ring. I mean, it's easily done with the, if you go and get all these secret Oopy locations. I don't know exactly how many there are, but there's not that many. They're not... I mean, some of them are common sense, some of them are like, what the heck? How would anyone ever figure out this was here? I guess some guy just went around when the game first came out and just started burning bushes with his candle to figure out where all the secret locations were. Don't ask me how they found this out, but... Anyways, I think there was a secret Oopy location right over here that I just skipped. Yeah, it's in this wall right here. You need bombs, so let's do that. Okay. Head in. I mean, I wish they would have made these guys say something different each time. It's a secret to everybody. They say the exact same thing. I mean, I know it's an old game, and it was like, wow, he's just said something that's so cool, but I don't know. Okay, I believe there's one more secret Oopy location around this area. And then once we head over the bridge right there, later on, there's going to be three more secret Oopy locations, so... Yeah, this one's right here in this bush, so remember that. Let's see how many this guy gives us. 10, really? Whatever. Rupees are rupees. Here's a fairy. Oh, yeah. Okay, now we have full hearts, we get our magical attack back. There's 5 rupees. Okay, now let's head across the bridge and start, getting secret Oopy locations over here. What the heck? I just got hit by the Octorok's rock and got shot in here. In here is, the old lady that you want to give this letter to. Once you give her the letter, you'll be able to buy potions from now on. There are many locations throughout Hyrule, so be sure to do that. I'm not going to get any just because I'm saving for the blue ring, and that's a lot more helpful. So yeah, to get, yeah, there's 3 secret Oopy locations, like I said, over here. So let's head to them. Got some blue moblins on the way, so let's take them out. Over here, we need bombs to get to this one. It's in the wall right here. In this yeah, I got the exact spot, not bad. It's a secret to everybody, same thing said every single time. Okay, now we're gonna need to take our candle back out because the last 2 locations require the candle. You can also hurt enemies with the fire if for some reason you didn't know that. Head right. That little area right there is like a maze, and wow. Okay, I've already used, if you, like I said, when we first got the blue candle, you can only use the fire once per screen, and if you do that accidentally, just change screens, it's not a big deal. Later on in the game, we'll get an upgrade where, ooh, 100 rupees. Okay, I'm guessing we're not gonna get, need to get that last rupee, location, just because we already have maxed out our counter, and don't go and get rupees if you've maxed out your counter, because you're just wasting them. Save them for later. We're really close to where the blue ring is right now, so might as well not fight anybody. There's no point. Another thing, if you saw just a few seconds ago where I hurt myself with the candle by walking into the fire, that's another thing. You can hurt yourself with the candle in this game, which is kind of dumb. It's like, it seems like it would be one of the least, like, powerful weapons in the game, and you can hurt yourself with it and get away. And here is the blue ring. Boy, this is really expensive. You bet it is. I mean, dang. It's like all your rupees gone, and I always like sitting here and watching them all go down. Yeah, I think we've gotten all the items that we need on the overworld. All we need to do next is head for the first dungeon. Okay. So let's head there real quick. Dang, I'm almost dead. Stupid Armos. Just, I hate how some of the Armos, when you hit them, don't do anything. And then some of them, like, go crazy and just run everywhere. Like, freaking out. I don't know. Come on, someone drop a heart. Okay, like I said, the blue ring gives you double the health, so enemies that only hurt you half a health, half a heart before, need to hit you twice to actually do damage, which is kinda cool. Okay, two hearts, dang, not bad. Okay, head right up here alongside the lake, and, alright, this isn't the right location yet. Keep following the water. Just keep following. Just keep swimming. Just keep swimming. Reference to Nemo right there, if you've seen that movie. Okay, head across this bridge, and right here is the first dungeon. But, I think we've done a lot in this video, guys, so I think we're gonna end things off here. But in the next episode, everybody, we're going to take on the Eagle, the name of the first dungeon, alright? So, I will see you guys then.